On Mars, Mount Olympus, or Olympus Mons, as it is known in Latin, is the solar system's largest known volcano. It is a shield volcano. Rather than violently spewing molten material, shield volcanoes are created by lava slowly flowing down the sides. The massive shield volcano is almost practically made up of basalt lava flows. It towers at about 16 miles, 25 kilometers, above Mars's surface and has a diameter of 374 miles, 600 kilometers, making it roughly the size of Arizona. It would just about fit within the boundaries of France. It is so enormous that it could be recognized as a separate feature on telescopes as early as the 19th century. But it wasn't until 1971, when NASA's Mariner 9 spacecraft arrived in orbit around Mars, that the nature of Mount Olympus was established not only as an outstanding mountain, but also as a volcano. This volcano, which is roughly three times the height of Mount Everest, the highest point on Earth, must have had a lot of activity and eruptions to grow to the size it is now. Because Olympus Mons is so large, the lava must have been quite runny, resulting in the smooth slopes that are seen. However, scientists don't believe the volcano has erupted recently. They believe it last erupted about 4 billion years ago, and because of this, they concluded that it is a dormant volcano, one that is at rest because there isn't much lava movement visible. After reviewing many photographs and scientific data obtained by satellites and rovers on Mars, they came to this conclusion. Also, they examined the rock in great detail and calculated the ages of the rocks visible on the surface. The rocks on the surface are cold, since they have had plenty of time to cool down from the last time they erupted from the volcano. The average temperature of Mars today is minus 63 degrees Celsius, which is quite low. Temperatures must be extremely high for a volcano to erupt and melt rocks into lava. So, Olympus Mons would have been far hotter billions of years ago. When lava erupts from volcanoes on Earth, it can reach temperatures of 700 degrees Celsius to 1,200 degrees Celsius. Volcanoes in Hawaii are more or less similar to Olympus Mons, in that they have very wide bases and very gentle slopes. Although volcanoes in Hawaii are much smaller, they are very similar. When lava gets hotter, it becomes runnier, and we know that the lava on Olympus Mons was runny because of the lengthy slopes observed. So, the lava must have been extremely hot for it to be runny. And if it was similar to the volcanoes in Hawaii, the lava would have been around 1,200 degrees Celsius. If the lava had been any colder, it would not have been able to flow down the sides of the volcano, resulting in extremely steep slopes as it accumulated up near the top of the volcano. This would result in the formation of a different type of volcano, known as the stratovolcano. These types of volcanoes exist here on Earth, such as Mount St. Helens in the United States. Why would such a massive volcano erupt on Mars, but not on Earth? Scientists think that the red planet's lower surface gravity, combined with faster eruption rates, allowed the lava to pile up higher. The presence or absence of tectonic plates may also impact the different types of volcanoes that exist. On both planets, the lava hotspots under the crust remain in the same location. However, the movement of the crust on Earth hinders the continuous buildup of lava. For example, the Hawaiian Islands, formed as a plate, drifted over a hot spot. Each eruption resulted in the formation of a little island in a different spot. However, plate movement on Mars is quite limited. Both the hot spot and the crust have remained stationary. When lava reaches the surface, it piles up in a single spot. Large volcanoes, such as Olympus Mons, form instead of a series of volcanic islands. Although we can't visit Olympus Mons in person, we can learn a lot about the rocks and how they formed by using satellites and rovers as well as comparing them to similar volcanoes here on Earth. The more we learn about Mars as a planet, the more we'll be able to determine its past environment and how it evolved into what we observe today. If you like this video, please consider subscribing and click the notification bell so you do not miss any upcoming videos.